The displacement, velocity and acceleration, how they are compared. Now here I am drawing along x-axis, I am drawing time, and y-axis I am taking displacement. Now the graph between them is here the variation of the displacement, velocity and acceleration is along this is the x-axis. Now here, now this is the displacement and this is the mean position and this is extreme position plus A, and this is the extreme position in the another side, this is in the negative side, that is minus. And next this is the velocity. Here this velocity this is one complete time period and this is mean position. At extreme position the maximum velocity is A omega plus A omega and maximum velocity is minus A omega in the negative side. Now in this acceleration, that acceleration is plus A omega square along positive and minus A omega square along negative side. Now here the acceleration graph is along this time. Here this is the time period here. Now if we compare this displacement, velocity and acceleration, here this is the displacement and this is the velocity and this is the acceleration along y-axis. Next, in this if we observe the displacement at this is the mean position, and at the extreme position the velocity, the displacement is maximum at this point. And when it comes to mean position, again the displacement is zero, and again in the opposite direction at maximum and at extreme position it is maximum. Now if you observe the velocity is maximum at mean position, the velocity is maximum at mean position and zero at the extreme position. Here if we compare this acceleration, the acceleration is maximum at extreme position and minimum at mean position. Now if we observe the phase angles of this displacement, velocity and acceleration, here displacement y is equal to a sin omega t, and velocity, if we take velocity, v is equal to a omega cos omega t, and this a omega cos omega t we can write a omega sin omega t plus pi by 2. Here this pi by 2 is the phase difference between displacement and velocity and acceleration. If we take acceleration, then acceleration a is equal to minus a omega square sin omega t. This we can write minus a omega, that is minus omega square, minus a omega square sin omega t plus pi we can write. That means the displacement and acceleration are at a phi phase different. They are at phi phase different because here it is started at a mean position and the maximum at a positive direction. Here it is maximum at the negative direction. That's why when we compare this displacement, velocity and acceleration, these are the variations of the displacement velocity acceleration of simple harmonic motion of particle. Now, if for example a particle is executing simple harmonic motion, then the displacement of a particle is given y is equal to 0.02 sine 3.14 t plus 5/2. Then this is the displacement of a particle executing simple harmonic motion is given. Now we have to calculate displacement, velocity, accelerations, amplitude, approach, phase angle. These all we have to calculate. To calculate these values, first we have to compare this equation by y is equal to a sine omega t plus phi. Now from this we can get the amplitude a is equal to, here in the place of a it is having 0.02 meter. This is the amplitude of a particle. And next time period, the time period t is equal to 2 pi by omega. Here 2 pi by omega is equal to, in the place of omega here 3.14 we have. Then t is equal to 2 into pi value 3.14 by 3.14 gets cancelled. T is equal to, we can get 2 seconds. This is the time period of simple harmonic motion executing particle. Now frequency, this frequency we can calculate nu is equal to 1 by time period, that is 1/2, it means 0.5 hertz. This is the frequency of a particle. Now approach, here approach phi is equal to, already in the place of phi it is having π/2 radians. This is the approach of a particle. And velocity maximum, here the velocity maximum value is a into omega, then a value 0.02 into omega value already we have, that is 3.14. we can get .0628, that is meter per second. This is the velocity maximum value. And next acceleration, this acceleration is equal to, we can write a maximum, that is a omega square. Here a omega square, if we calculate this a omega square value, then we can get 0.1972 meter per second square. This is the acceleration value. These are the values we can calculate by the equation, if any equation is given, that is the displacement of a particle.